Hello, everyone, and welcome to FAQ Fridays. Today, we are going to be talking about five reasons why you should use snow retention on your metal roof. My name is Curtis Ward with S5, and I'm joined today by Rob Haddock. Rob is a well-known expert and consultant in the field of metal roofing. He has written over 100 technical articles and industry standards on the subject and won numerous awards for his writings from ASTM, CSI, and the Metal Construction Association. He also lectures countless audiences of contractors, architects, engineers, and roofing consultants on metal roofing. Rob is also S5's founder and CEO. Rob, thanks for taking your time to chat with us today.
Sure, Curtis. I understand you have some questions for me about snow, roofs, and snow retention on roofs.
I do, and I'm told you're an expert on the subject, so let's dive in. Rob, first off, what is meant by snow retention? What is that?
Snow retention, or snow guards, are devices or systems that retain snowpack on the roof so that it can evacuate the roof slowly and predictably through thaw and evaporation rather than suddenly and unpredictably in avalanche fashion, which can be damaging and dangerous.
And why is this a particular concern on metal roof?
Well, metal roofing is a good choice in any climate because of its durability and expected service life, more than 40 years. Notably, a characteristic of metal is that it has a low coefficient of friction. So in simple terms, it's a slippery slope. So in a northern climate, snow and ice are prone to sliding off unexpectedly. While this may seem to many people to be a desirable thing, it can also be a nuisance and even a danger. Have a look at this video, for example. What you just saw was between 5 and 6 tons of snow avalanche from that small roof in just under 5 seconds. It can be rather dramatic. Now that may seem exciting or cool to watch that video, but if your children were building a snowman under that eave, it could also be rather sobering. And that isn't just hypothetical. A couple of years ago, that very thing happened in Idaho. And just last year, 2 more lives were lost in the Sierras near Lake Tahoe. Several years prior to that, a Forest Service guy also lost his life in Idaho.
That is pretty sobering. So what causes those types of rooftop avalanches?
Well, with the aid of some graphics here, I can explain it. During a snowstorm, as snow piles up on the roof, the sunlight is occluded from the roof, and snowpack is retained on the roof by 2 different bonds. There is a temperature-sensitive frictional bond between the blanket of snow and the roof. If this is a little difficult to comprehend, think of the old tongue on the runner of a sled scenario. It's the same sort of thing that happens on your roof. There's also a cohesive bond up at the ridge, one blanket on either side of the ridge cohering to each other. And it's a combination of those 2 bonds that are resisting the drag load or gravity load of the snow, which is trying to slide off the roof. So there's both friction involved as well as a cohesive bond. If the vector forces, that drag load that's indicated there with the blue arrow, if those loads or vector forces exceed the strength of those 2 bonds, then the avalanche will occur. So what happens is the next day when the storm is cleared and the sun comes out, the sun's rays shine through the somewhat translucent bank of snow, warming the surface of the roof below that snowbank. As the surface warms, that temperature-sensitive frictional bond is freed. Not only is that bond now freed, but the roof is now also lubricated by meltwater. This can happen when temperatures, ambient temperatures, are well below freezing, because the snow blanket insulates the roof, and the roof surface absorbs the UV rays of the sun, which warms it above the freezing point. The entire drag load now is experienced by the cohesive bond at the ridge, which is too weak, and the avalanche occurs. And that's the science of what causes rooftop avalanches.
Are there other hazards associated with rooftop avalanches?
Yes, there are. Damage to roof and other building elements can be another expensive hazard. Other property damage, such as damage to vehicles below, damage to landscape, and of course the nuisance of repeated snow removal. All these things are exacerbated the higher above the ground the roof is, as you can appreciate from these videos. These cars are parked along the street below this avalanche.
Wow, pictures are worth a thousand words, aren't they? Are there many sources to purchase these types of snow retention systems to protect yourself from these types of hazards?
Yes, there are, Kurt, fortunately or unfortunately.
Why do you say that?
Well, Curtis, there's a good deal of science, testing, and engineering that should go into any snow guard application on any given structure. There are specific forces in play that any given system must be designed to resist. It gets pretty technical, but the field of snow retention is completely unregulated.
And what do you mean by that?
Well, simply put, there are no snow guard police. Anyone can produce some sort of device, hang out their shingle, and sell it on the open market without ever doing all the necessary testing, engineering, and quality control in production to be sure that the system is adequate and won't structurally fail when you put it on your roof. So it's very much a buyer beware kind of scenario.
So how can a home or facility owner go about selecting the right system?
That's a good question, and one that any buyer of a system like that should ask. There's an industry trade group out there called the Metal Construction Association. They've published a couple of technical bulletins to assist in that very thing. They're free downloads from MCA's website, metalconstruction.org. They can be found in the technical resource section of that website. The first is called Metal Roof Design for Cold Climates, and the second is called Qualifying Snow Retention Systems for Metal Roofing.
So may I assume that S5 complies with all the do's and don'ts set out in those documents?
Of course. To my knowledge, in fact, we're the only company in the United States, or of all of North America, that does and always has. We've been in the business for 27 years now and have never had a documented failure of one of our systems. That's because we do follow those prescriptive guidelines, and always have, even before those documents were created.
So thank you, Rob, for your time today and all your great insight on snow retention.
Thanks for the opportunity to share it all, anytime. There's far more to this subject than can possibly be covered in a short interview like this one. But there's a plethora of information on our website at s5.com, s-5, don't forget the hyphen.com.
All right. So now that you've heard those five reasons why you should use snow retention on your metal roof, visit our website, like Rob said, at s-5.com and check out all of S5's snow retention systems. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in today. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe for more great resources. And if you have a question that you want answered yourself, be sure to comment below. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you next Friday.
Down live. Look,
are there many sources to protect?
Follow those prescriptive. Do follow those prescriptive. Want me to hold the mic? Give him a shot of whiskey.